and we're delighted with her. You know, she had a nice easy 3 weeks. She put on 22 kilos during that time, and you wouldn't know it looking at her. She's so big, you know, she put it on in all areas. You know, we're just building her back up now into full routine, and she'll do a couple of pieces of work next week.
And is the arc the intended end of season target at this stage for her?
You'd like to think so, but I mean, the Yorkshire Oaks will tell us a lot on trip, etc. You know, we'd certainly be sort of having that in our mind at the moment. I mean, if by a chance, and I don't think it will come to that, that she didn't stay the mile and a half or not look as though she did, then we have the Prix Vermeil as a backup, and you know, the couple of mile and a quarter races. But I don't see any problem with staying a mile and a half. I never really doubted that he wouldn't train on. A few good judges told me he wouldn't last year, and but I always had it in my head he would. It was always going to be very tough for him, and I said that from day one. You know, he's a 5 furlong horse, and those 5 furlong, the programme for the Commonwealth is brilliant and a great conception, but it's a 6 furlong and 7 furlong horses, really. You know, if they're just 5 furlongs, they've got to take the older horses on, and it's tough for those sprinters at 3, even getting a bit of weight. So we always had it in our mind that we might struggle early season with Havana Grey, and this time of year, you know, June, July onwards, the 3-year-olds come into their own against the older horses, and hopefully he'll carry on now, proving himself to be a top-class sprinter.
Is the plan the Nunthorpe for him?
Yeah, but he'd probably take in Goodwood along the way. He's obviously handled the track. He won the Molcombe there last year. It's a very valuable Group 2. It's a tough race. It's a Group 1 in all but name, really. So as long as he's shown us signs that he's fit and well, which I see no reason why he shouldn't go there, we'd only be galloping him at home in preparation for the Nunthorpe anyway, and he's a horse who needs his work. So that's the plan.
Okay, and another talented two-year-old you had was Unfortunately. What's the plan for him?
Unfortunately, he could turn up in France the Sunday after Goodwood for the Maurice de Geest. Stepping him up to the 6.5. Hopefully there's decent ground out there. He came out of Ascot really well as we could expect after running on the very fast ground. And I know 4 lengths is a long way in a sprint, but Tony Picone, who rode him that day, you know, he was slow away, which wasn't Tony's fault. He wasn't that slow out the stalls, but he was slow into his stride and the fast ground, and they go so quick early there. You know, they took him off his feet and he got it a bit detached, but stayed on really well into the race. And Tony, a typical French style, sort of, once he couldn't win, he literally sat up at the half furlong marker, but unfortunately kept passing horses even under no ride at all, basically, just being held together, and got beat sort of just over 4 lengths at the line. So We're in our mind, he could have been a length or two closer than that, which would have put him sort of fifth or sixth on the tails of the placed horses, which is a good run on ground that's too quick for him.
And another good two-year-old you had, Elthea. What's the plan with her now?
Yeah, she's pretty ground dependent. You know, she likes that, to get a toe in. You know, and the summer we've had, we've just been stuck with her, really. She'll have entries and prepare her for an autumn campaign. She really came into her own last autumn as well, and I think it's going to be the same this year, and you know, September onwards will be her time.
Okay, plenty of other exciting horses you've got. Have you got any two-year-olds at the minute that you're particularly excited about, whether they ran or not ran, that we need to keep our eyes open for?
There's a few, thankfully. We ran a very nice colt of Khalifa Dasmel's in the pre-Robin Papin at Maison Lafitte last Sunday. Ran a great race. He was outside of the five runners, and John Quinn's Queen Mary horse won the race, but we were only beaten sort of just over a length, fraction over a length, and ran a very good race on ground that was a bit quick for him. He's a horse to keep an eye on. There's a couple of very nice Scat Daddies in the yard, and we're very hopeful that them, among others, will come to the fore. You know, we've got a lovely Dark Angel filly for later on of John Dance's as well. So there's plenty to look forward to.